Those jungle bunnies aren't without their own peculiar brand of decency. Give you an example. They wouldn't kill a chap while he was asleep. Had to wake him up because one of them, charming fella, lips like inner tubes, told me, under torture, naturally, that should the victim's spirit be out of his body at the time of death, it would, on its return, be so outraged it would pursue and torment the assassin for eternity. Like the Greek harpyx of mythology. Understandable if you believe that sort of guff.
Lady Philippa yawned behind her hand, and her dentures, ancient, yellowed, and imperfect, locked. With her cavernous mouth wide open, she could only, and Sir Henry, savvying she was gaping with wonderment at his yarn, gave her a boozy wink. She was too polite to leave the room, and Henry, now refueled with several great gulps of Southampton red rum, a brainstorming cocktail involving a large port, vodka, rum, and horseradish sauce, continued.
These are the only spirits I want tormenting my body. Personally, when you're dead, you're gone. After life, after shave, don't hold with any of it.
He glared at Great Aunt Florrie, who was of quite a different opinion, an almost chandelier with piskies, St. Christopher, crucifix, rabbit's foot and lucky whale's teeth about her neck.
I don't give a toss what you've done with me when I've shrugged off me mortal coil. Shove a bit of flex up me back passage, stick a light bulb in me mouth and stand me in the hall. Mind you, if you're using electricity, you'll have to dry me out first.
Florrie had once mentioned instant karma to Henry, but he thought it was some kind of tranquilizer. There was really little point now. He was too far gone.
Consulting a book called Itching before she goes to the bog? God's teeth, what did I marry?
Florrie smoothed the now graying hairs back from her temples and tucked them neatly under her flying buttresses. Thank Clapton, she thought, that John's early death precluded him from knowing what kind of swine his father really was. She recalled the affair of the rubbers, but there had been happier times. She sighed deeply, and her mind strode back some 30 years on sensible brogue feet. Henry, in uniform, the blink of brass buttons, then after, to dance the night away. What foolishness now it seemed to a woman, already in the twilight of her autumn. Yet what a kind man he'd always been. She recalled the time Mr. Cumberpatch, the gardener, sweet old chap, hated wasps, always wore bicycle clips when mowing the lawn, had fallen badly in the orchard and broken his leg. Why, Henry fairly raced back to the house for his pistol. He couldn't bear to see even the lowliest of creatures in pain. Again she heard the Black & Decker two-speed drill start horribly up in the downstairs bathroom, and the high-pitched screams of Sir Henry doing his own fillings. Curious how the Rawlinson family distrusted dentists. She remembered the night of Arbuthnot's honeymoon in Vienna. He knew he could never face his new wife without a huge and immediate extraction. And so he fastened a length of string about the tooth that pained him and the other end to the door of the cage-like lift and waited. But to no effect. The lift ascended, and nothing happened. Tearing open the iron door, Arbuthnot immediately threw himself down the shaft. Few men would have had the intelligence to do that. You know, Rafe could play billiards on horseback before he was 14.
Well, I could play blow football with my bottom when I was a youngster. Now, about these chaps, they put a hand on your chest to wake you up. One chink of reality, you're gone. Slit your throat, gouge your eyes out, no compunction. I remember I was alone in my tent when I felt it. I was enjoying a fitful rest when suddenly I felt it. The nuisance was I was so full of cold mackerel pie, I knew I'd have to blow off. Imagine the fix. I was at bursting point when the thing yerked into my face. Turned out I'd been lying there with a bloody great frog on my chest for an hour. Didn't have the heart to kill it, but I twisted its arm, something rotten.
I was in Africa, began Tarquin Maynard portly. Don't want to talk gibberish, but I spent some time in the land of the gibber,
And believe me, those jibwos could get a budgerig out to phone Howard's.
Oh, canny as a Campbell, Maynard, said Philippa Portly, nay, Maynard.
Maynards? So much incest in that family, even the bulldog's got a club foot.
Aye, but the flash of the clay pipes, the skirl of the mores. Profoundly moved, serpent chakra shivering, speed Bonnie Bower, Philippa gave tongue.
We are